What is up, everyone? This is going to be gig log number 8, I believe. We are on our way to do Midview's virtual red carpet event / prom.
1, 2, 3, jump!
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another gig log. This is gonna be gig log number 8, checking in with you guys. Now, as you may or may not be able to tell, this is a couple months after the actual gig happened and was filmed and everything like that. I didn't get much footage from the actual event, so I'm going to sit here and kind of explain a couple things that actually happened at the event. So if you may or may not be able to tell, this is actually being filmed a couple months after the event actually took place. So the event took place back at the end of May, and it was a virtual prom / red carpet event for my old high school that I actually graduated from. So this event kind of got put into motion back at the beginning of May when, you know, prom time was kind of coming around and my school, my old school, had not really announced what they were really doing for prom. And I just truly feel bad for all of the seniors that were not going to get to experience anything or some sort of prom for their senior year, because I know how much I truly enjoyed my prom and my senior year events and stuff like that. So I got in contact with some of the administration, my old broadcasting teacher, stuff like that, and we were able to throw some stuff together. And voila, here is what actually happened, and here is how the gig actually went. So I don't have that much footage from the actual gig log because we were super stressed out, and I'll kind of explain that maybe later on in the video of what all happened and stuff like that. But basically, we, DJM Entertainment, me and Kyle, we actually kind of put heads together and decide some cool things that we're going to be able to do. We're going to be able to do a live stream event of a red carpet walkthrough event. So like what you'd see in Hollywood, stuff like that. You'd be able to walk down the red carpet. It would be filmed and broadcasted live onto YouTube for all the parents and guardians to see of their students. So it was going to be a really cool thing. And then afterwards, we're going to do a Google Hangout call and actually DJ live and have like interaction, stuff like that, as a virtual prom. Now, some things did end up getting cut due to various things with YouTube and various things with administration, stuff like that. So we weren't able to actually live stream the red carpet event, but we actually did end up live streaming the DJ portion of it on my YouTube channel, and you guys can actually go check that out. That should be the last video unless it got copyrighted for whatever reason. So you'll see some clips from behind the scenes of actually that part of the event. Now, like I said, I don't have that many clips from actually setting up and anything like that because we were a little stressed out. But it was still a super fun event, super great event. So I'm gonna go ahead and show the clips of what I do have, and then afterwards I'll go ahead and explain a couple things and how this all kind of came together and what equipment we used and stuff like that. So go ahead, check out these couple clips I actually got. It's not much, and I'll be right back to explain some things. So I don't know how much footage I'll actually have from this event today, but it is a virtual prom and virtual red carpet event. So basically students will be arriving to the high school, my old high school that I used to go to. They will be walking the red carpet, and we were going to live stream it, but that is probably going to be cut due to like legal reasons and stuff like that, which meh, whatever. But we'll still be recording and stuff and setting up most of the equipment, and then I'll be DJing as well, doing a live stream on my YouTube page actually from 10 p.m. until 12 a.m. tonight. So yeah, we're going to set it up. Got video stuff, audio stuff, whole bunch of stuff, lots of equipment. Rented some gear, borrowed some gear from some buddies and stuff, and I'll be sure to give them a special shout out during the video. But yeah, like I said, I don't know how many clips we're actually going to get of today, but we will try and film. But I figured I would try and do a gig log for this event that we are doing through DJM Entertainment, which is the company. So stay tuned, stick around, and stay healthy out there, folks. What is up, vlog number 8? I'm doing a quick update right now. We're ready. We're set up in the backyard. I know I don't have any clips from actually setting up at the school, but I will stitch in part of the school clips
sometime in this video or whatever. We've been really rushed. I'll explain later and stuff. But yeah, check out the live stream.
Let's post below.
Alright, well, I told you guys I didn't have that many clips. I think there were like three clips that were solid and decent that I actually put into the gig log. So I'm going to go ahead and explain a couple things about the event and what we actually ended up doing and using and stuff like that. So our first up part of the event was the red carpet live stream event. Now it didn't end up being a live stream, but we still set up exactly like we were going to live stream because it was going to be a great practice run for the evening where we need to make it count and we didn't want to mess up anything. So we kind of troubleshooted some things during the first actual hour of the event. The first event was 3 hours long. It was from like 5 to 8 or like 4 to 7 or something like that, where everybody came, walked the red carpet, got some video done of them, got some photos, stuff like that. It was a really awesome event for the seniors. I really enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun, but we were super stressed out because we were originally going to be outside and then the weather just decided to not cooperate, and so we were actually inside of the gym. And so we set up everything. We had to run a little bit longer cables and stuff like that. So that was basically the event. I just DJed a little bit, practicing some of my sets I was going to be using later in the night for the actual live stream on the YouTube page. And that was another change too. We were going to do a Google Hangout call, but we didn't end up doing that. We did a live stream on YouTube instead so that everyone could see. So some of you that are viewing this video might have tuned into the actual live stream and you may be thinking, how did he do that? How did he accomplish that? Well, get ready because I'm going to tell you how I did it. So actually a lot of this came together because of Kyle's help and his knowledge as well, with a little bit of live streaming and cameras and video and audio equipment and stuff like that. So we kind of put our heads together. We had a couple, you know, Zoom calls socially distanced because he was out in Tiffin and I was in Elyria, Ohio. And so we had to like call each other a bunch, get all the right equipment stuff and settle down. So we actually ended up using some of his equipment, some of the equipment from my high school's broadcasting room, some of my equipment, and then I ended up renting a few things and picking another piece up from my other roommate, actually, who lived down in Medina, Ohio. So I'm going to kind of explain how we set it up and how we did the live streaming part, because the typical DJ part was just like any other setup. It was my Pioneer DDJ 1000, it was the two EV ZLX speakers, and then actually I did just upgrade my lights right before this event because they had a great sale on idjnow.com for 25% off Chauvet lighting use accessories and lighting kits and stuff like that, as well as just the lights in general. So I went ahead and picked up two Chauvet Wash Effects 2s and they are awesome. And then I also got from my buddy who's actually getting out of DJing his ADJ Airstream DMX Bridge, which was awesome. So I was able to control the lights and I'm still learning how to use that a little bit, but hopefully I'll get a little bit better. So the DJing side of things was typical as be. I had my speakers, I had my mixer, had my laptop running record box DJ, and then I had my lights. That was about it. Now where the fun part came in is how we're going to live stream, incorporate the video and the audio as well from my mixer and from an announcer at the red carpet live stream event. So how we did it is we used OBS first off for running all the video and audio all together into one computer. So we used Kyle's MacBook Pro and we ran OBS on the computer. So using OBS, we were able to stream to many different platforms. We had our options between Twitch, Facebook, Twitter, I think even, and YouTube. So we ended up going with YouTube because it's one of the most simplest streaming platforms. Anybody can get on, access the link. You don't have to have an account unless you want to interact with the video, which is either like, subscribing, commenting, stuff like that. And you can also create the link days ahead and put it out on blast and stuff so that people can, you know, have it in their reference or whatever, like bookmark it or something like that. Highly recommend YouTube for your streaming. It was really awesome. I'm sure Twitch is just as good, but Twitch is not as popular as YouTube currently. I feel like it's getting a little more popular with, you know, the certain circumstances with COVID-19, everything like that. A lot of people are switching to Twitch, but I actually ended up using YouTube and YouTube was awesome. So we use YouTube and OBS together, and then we also use OBS Link, which was for the Elgato capture card. So that gets a little into video, so I guess I can go ahead and go down that route. So for video, we actually ended up using two cameras. We used my personal camera, which is the Canon 80D or 80D. And then we also used Kyle's camera, which is a Sony. It's an Alpha something. I don't really exactly know the model, but it's a super nice camera. And so we actually ended up using both of them for two various camera angles on the live stream. Now, I've seen a bunch of people do webcams and use webcams, which is awesome. I mean, I think they personally probably look better for that circumstance, like using for it for live stream only. But the problem was I didn't really want to go out and spend or try and find or track down or rent webcams just for this one event when I had two perfectly good DSLR cameras ready to be used at my disposal and stuff. Even though like we had some issues with overheating with Kyle's camera, and then my camera also, like the HDMI out port is a little funky and stuff. You have to turn off a couple different things on the actual camera settings because it's not a clean HDMI output. Some camera people will probably know what I'm talking about, others won't, but that's okay. And so it worked. I would recommend it, but if you are really like just getting into this and stuff and you're trying to like go basic, just get a webcam and stuff. If you're only going to be doing streaming, but if you're going to be doing other stuff, like I film gig logs and stuff, and this is perfect for filming gig logs. I also shoot photography sometimes. So I have the Canon 80D, which is awesome. So I use that for video along with Kyle's Sony camera. And typically with the webcams, you can kind of just plug it in USB. It's like a USB adapter or something to your computer, and then they'll all link up and stuff like that. That is not the same case for certain DSLR cameras, including both of our cameras. You actually have to run an HDMI cord out, and then most computers, you can't really like input an HDMI into the computer. At least we didn't think that way. But what we did have at our disposal was a Roland video switcher. So I'll go ahead and stitch in a clip of what the actual Roland video switcher looked like. This was a piece that was borrowed from the high school broadcasting room. I used it all throughout my years broadcasting from the high school. It was a really awesome piece of equipment. I'm really super glad that we got to be able to use it because it made things super interesting and super unique and stuff, because not many people out there have like an actual video switcher that they can do different effects and stuff. Although we may have not taken advantage of like every effect, it was still neat to have and stuff. And you saw it in some of the clips, Kyle like switching back and forth and stuff between the two videos. So that is how we ran our video. It was like a Roland V4, so it had four different HDMI inputs that we could use, but we only used two. And so we ran both the HDMIs into there. It gave us our video, and then we ran one HDMI cable out to the Elgato HD60S, which was actually my buddy Nolan's that lives in Medina. He's a streamer. Go check him out on Facebook, Aviator Gamer. Awesome guy. Anyways, we ran it into the Elgato and then into Kyle's MacBook as a HDMI in, or no, it was actually USB. So it actually took a USB into the computer, not HDMI. And that's how we were able to do all the video. So we did not have any microphones or any lines attached to the Roland switcher, even though we could have, but I didn't really think of it that way, and I really didn't figure out a clean way to be able to do it and stuff, because like the Roland video switcher is made for video switching, not so much for audio, and so we really didn't have control over the audio per se when we were just using the Roland video switcher. So that's how we did the video. So next up, and probably what was the most important thing, was the audio equipment that we actually use. So video, you can kind of give or take when you're doing these live streams, because people care about having like clear video, but they really want to hear the sound, especially when you're DJing and stuff. The sound has to be crystal clear source audio, excuse me there. So I really wanted to go all out that I could for the sound. So I started Googling a couple different options, but I was also dealing with a budget. I kind of wanted to keep this low budget and stuff, so I didn't have to put out a lot of expenses. And I came across the Rode SC4, which is a little dongle that actually has like a 3.5 headphone and microphone jack that runs in, and then it comes out a headphone and microphone jack as well. They can plug into like your phone or your computer, anything like that. And so I ordered one. It was back ordered. Then my order got canceled, and it was this whole thing, and I didn't end up getting the thing on time. So it came down to crunch time, and I was thinking, I was like, well, there's another option that I can go. I can get a standalone preamp mixer, but it has to have a USB out, which can run from analog sound to digital sound. Now, I know I may be speaking Chinese or, you know, gobbledygook for some people, but other people understand what I'm trying to get across here. So I thought to myself, hey, I know these rental guys are really cool out in Parma. Joe, my homie from ohiosound.com, I think that's the website. I forget what the actual name of the company is. They change it every now and then. But it's a rental house out in Parma, which is only about a 20-minute drive from my house, which is really awesome. So I called up Joe, and I'm like, hey, man, do you have any of these standalone mixers that have to have a USB out? He's like, yeah, I think I got a couple. And then he goes, actually, I think my company, Pearl Sound, excuse me, I'm sorry, Joe, Pearl Ridge Sound, my bad. Pearl Ridge Sound, which is his company that designs and manufactures different mixers and a whole bunch of other stuff. He's like, yeah, I got this right here for you. So I go down there, check it out. Worked awesome. So I brought it back and I actually used that. So it was a standalone preamp mixer, but it also had an amp built in, which is really awesome. So if you needed like amp power for some passive speakers or anything like that, it had it built in right there. But thankfully I didn't need that. All my speakers are powered and stuff. Power's the way to go. But anyways, so I ran on my DDJ 1000, there is a section called boost out. So I originally tried to use that, but then that wasn't working correctly, or maybe I was just kind of a noob and I had the wrong button switched or whatever. Anyways, I ended up just using the RCA out on my master out. Took that, ran a cable to two inputs, left and right on the mixer, patched it in using some quarter inch to RCA adapters, bada bing, bada boom, came out the USB right into the computer, and there I had analog to digital sound. So that was how I ran the sound actually for the event. Now, if I were to do another event in the future, I would probably want the same type of thing because it gave me so much leeway and like configuration and stuff right on the actual mixer versus just relying on like a cable to like amplify it and make sure the levels are okay and stuff, because once you run that cable, you really can't adjust the levels or anything. It's like we were coming in a little too hot to OBS, so I went in, I go ahead and turned it down, and then we were too quiet, so I turned it up a little bit, vice versa, stuff like that. So another thing that you may be able to tell is from my live stream, I actually had my speakers set up and they were, you know, blasting at a decent size volume and stuff. Well, I was controlling that with my main out knob on my actual mixer board. So about 3/4 of the way through, it was getting later in the night, so I turned it down a little bit, but that also ended up turning it down on the live stream. So I got to make note of that for next time, to not touch the main out knob if I'm using that same configuration. So that was how I did the sound. It was just a preamp mixer, ran an RCA line in and then out to the computer that was running OBS, patched it in, bada bing, bada boom, had my live stream. So that was really about it. It was just the video and the audio that I had to cover. Like I said, all my DJ stuff was the same as like any other gig that I would use. It was just virtually. So this was a really awesome thing that I was able to do. It allowed me to dabble in a new area that I've kind of like, I've done a little bit of work in, but I haven't really done that much. And it was awesome to be able to say that I have this now underneath my belt. And it was awesome to give back to my old high school that may have been struggling and stuff, you know, trying to come up with ideas for prom, when I kind of took charge and I was like, all right, let's do this event and stuff. And so that was really it for the event. There really wasn't much to it. I made it seem like a lot more, and I was super stressed out because we were running into cable issues and stuff. Don't order your cables off Amazon like I did at the very last second. Don't do it. Get them from a professional person like Hosa or some other professional sound grade person, because I ran into so many issues, especially with the cheap RCA cable that I ended up buying. So yeah, just a couple quick shout outs to some homies that really helped me harness and do this event. It was really awesome. So Kyle, number one, my homie G from the OG. So he really helped me out. He brought in some equipment, brought in his expertise, and he was there through the entire event with me as my sidekick slash roadie. So thank you very much for helping out. And of course, Nolan, Aviator Gamer Mod Man from Medina, Ohio. He gave me the HD60S Elgato capture card, which allowed me to capture the images and footage that we were using for both the red carpet event and for the live stream event. My homie Joe from ohiosound.com, I forget what the actual name of the establishment is, but he owns Pearl Ridge Sound. I got the name correct. There we go. Pearl Ridge Sound. Check out his products and his company. Buy some stuff. I'm not sponsored, but that would be pretty cool if I could be. And then, of course, some administration from Midview, including Mrs. Slime and my old broadcasting teacher, Mrs. Zuch, which is the media coordinator for Midview, Mr. Flipiak, Mr. Fasca, Mrs. Passerell, and some others from the Midview administration that helped out and kind of snowballing this event and stuff and making it a big production, which I wanted it to be. And of course, shout out to my sister Izzy for helping along, and of course my mom for providing the pizza. Oh, that pizza was so good right before I went live stream, kind of pumped me up and stuff like that. So that's going to be it for gig log number 8. It's really been a cool thing to kind of dabble in and really try out some of my, you know, knowledge and stuff and use it towards providing some great entertainment virtually and stuff. So I really hope that COVID kind of, you know, hits the road here, packs up as we're coming into the fall season and stuff, because I really want to get back to doing like traditional events and stuff like that. But who knows where it's gonna go from here. So I will try and keep posting content if I get some. If I don't, I'm sorry. I'm just trying. Maybe I'll do a live stream in the future. Who knows? Because I kind of have some of the equipment and I'm back at college now. So Kyle lives like 10 steps of that way, which is awesome. But yeah, so thanks for sticking around. Thanks for checking out gig log number 8. Subscribe for all the latest and greatest content. Be sure to hit that notification bell so you get stay up to date with everything possible on Dean's channel. And of course, leave a comment down below and like this video. Thank you, homies, for checking out this video. And I'll catch you on the next one. Woo! Hey!